Hello and welcome to the channel once again. The name is Goroboy. So in this tutorial or in this video, we're going to talk about Brookram, the latest update which currently support iOS 16 on RAM disk on passcode activation or passcode bypass. So right over here, we do have the passcode or iPhone unavailable. So if you do have the iPhone unavailable or disable, then you can follow along with this tutorial. So if you do have happen to have the hello screen, then you have to check the description of the video and go into the hello or activation lock screen. So without wasting my time, let's run program this as an administrator. But before you do that, make sure to extract. If you do already have it, then you can run it directly. So click on check device and connect your device in normal mode. So but before you do that, just open your device manager and resize the device manager. I just want to make my desktop look clean for you. So here I do have my device manager to keep my eye on my drivers. So when you do open your device manager, you just have to connect your device to the phone computer. Okay, so let me show my phone on screen. So here I do have my phone being connected to the computer. So I'll have to put it into recovery mode. So when putting it into recovery mode, if you do know how to put your device into DFU mode, then you can do so. Since I want to show you how to put your device into DFU mode by using the Brookram disk DFU helper being added to the latest update. Okay, so our phone is being detected, so we have to move to the device manager right over here and move to universal serial bus controller and make sure that our Apple mobile device USB driver is being under the universal USB bus controller. Now check your device and we have our device showing in recovery mode. So just move to the DFU helper on the top right corner in Brook and you will have the DFU helper. Just click on start and press the key combination for your device to get your device into DFU mode. Okay, so if you are able to put your device into DFU mode, you receive a successful message saying your device is in DFU. So move to device manager and make sure you still have your Apple mobile device USB drivers and not device. So make sure you have the exact same drivers under universal serial bus. Now click on start and make sure that your EC, let me move back and show you how to register your serial number. You just have to copy your serial number. Since my device is already registered, I will not be able to move to the registration panel. So just click on register here and you'll be taken to the registration panel and paste in your ECID and register your ECID for free. So now click on start and before you do move to jailbreak option, make sure that you've downloaded the RAM disk type for your device. So here we do have the iOS versions and their RAM disk right over here. So for iOS 15, we do have iOS 15 RAM disk and we do have the alternative also. So if you do try the iOS 15 normal and it does not work, come in and try the alternative RAM disk in case you do have issue backing up your device. So in here I'm going to download the exact RAM disk for my device. So here I'll move to program this and check for my device type. So I do have the iPhone 9.3 D10 1 AP. So right over here we do have the iPhone 9.3 D10 1 AP zip file right over here. So just make sure to download it and after downloading it, make sure to copy or move the download the zip file to your Brookram disk and that Brookram disk move to RAM disk folder and make sure you do paste it in Brookram disk RAM disk folder. And after doing so, you can move back to the Brookram disk tool and click on start. So when you do click on start, you can now click on the jailbreak option. So click on jailbreak and it will start auto pan DFU in your device. So if in this step it fails to pan DFU your device, make sure to use the manual pan DFU option. which I've already talked about in the previous program days tutorial. So we do have successfully putting our device into Pandia FU, and it will start jailbreaking or exploiting our device with the RAM disk we downloaded. So just wait for a while for the device to start exploiting. Okay, so in the process of sending the RAM disk to your device may boot in random colors and finally stay on the white screen or gray screen. You do not have to panic, that's normal. So you just have to make sure you are being prompt SSH being connected successfully, then you can proceed. So if you do receive unsuccessful message, you have to check your drivers and click on next, and now you can back up your activation records. So in the process of backing up your device, if you have been stuck here, then you have to retain user data with 3U2 and update to iOS 15 or try the alternative RAM disk in the Mega website. Okay, so we successfully back up our device, so click on OK and you'll be prompted with a folder showing your backup file. So here we do have our backup file, so now we can go ahead and erase our device by clicking on erase button right over here. So just click on erase and click yes to accept that you want to erase your device, then wait for your device to boot up and erase all content on your device. So after erasing your device, you will be on the hello screen right over here, and you will not be able to activate your device since you don't know the Apple ID. So you just have to put our device into the FU mode. So if you don't know how to put your device into recovery or the FU, just do that. So if you are in recovery, just use the FU helper to get your device into the FU mode. So before we do proceed, just move to options and make sure skip setup after activation, make sure that one is being checked. And also if you are iOS 16, make sure that iOS 16 box is also checked. And that's it. Now you can proceed by moving back and clicking on check device. So click on check device and you will be with this successful message saying your device is being connected successfully. So just click start and wait for your device, and now you just might want to click on the jailbreak device. Just click on it and it will start pandfing your device. So if it fails to pandf your device, make sure to use the manual pandfu, which I've already made a video on it on program this previous video. So you just have to wait for the successful pandfing. So we do have successful pandfing our device, so we just have to wait for the RAM disk, or just wait for the program disk to start sending the RAM disk files to our device. So when the RAM disk has been sent to your device and SSH connected successfully, then you can click next. And also if you do fail on SSH, just make sure to check your drivers in device manager. So now we can activate our device, so by clicking on activate device. So just click on activate and just wait for a device to be activated. So after successful activating, your device should now reboot and you have a successful message saying your device has successfully been activated. And now you can wait for your device to boot up and also move back to program this and move to options, and you will find the developer right over there, his contact, and you might want to donate to support the tool. So right over here we do have our device on the, let's say, the lock screen. So you just have to click on the home key to get into our home screen. So right over here on our home screen we do have signal on our phone. So with this you'll be able to receive calls and also use Siri, FaceTime, and also iMessage will work, and you will be able to receive notification as well, and also signing in into your Apple ID from settings. And here let me show you that I'll be able to place call. So you will be able to place call and make calls. So you will be able to make call, receive call. So if your device is on already on hello screen, then you can use the program this Hello Bypass, which I'll leave the link for the video in the description. Make sure to check it out. Peace out.